This week is all about tossing. Tossing some music at you, tossing a beloved teacher into retirement, and tossing around some wood. It's all next on The Ekko. Good morning, HHS. I'm Sydney Cater. Today we have another awesome show for you on The Ekko. Check that calendar. It's a Thursday, the 18th of April of 2019. Earlier this month, members of our vocal and instrumental music groups got together for the Night of Jazz. The setting was at the Hastings Arts Center and the date was Saturday, April 6th. This night at the Jazz Club had been a great classy event being held for a number of years and has never failed to showcase some of our finest musicians.
Vocal jazz is a little bit smaller, so you kind of get a chance to like perform as if you were like performing as a soloist kind of. You get to use the mic, so that's super fun to just perform in like a smaller setting with a smaller group.
Our jazz groups are extremely talented, but they wouldn't be as amazing if we didn't have such great music teachers to guide us. Our music department is a huge part of who we are at HHS. This year, one fabulous teacher who has led kids and inspired through song is setting down her baton. To catch the story, let's tune into The Ekko's Cora Anderson.
Ready, go.
Here at HHS, we are lucky to have some amazing vocal teachers. But after 18 years...
I came when the building was new, so 2001.
One of our talented teachers is sadly retiring. Mrs. Hansen has been working at HHS since the building first opened.
I'll never forget it. I had 144 sophomores in my concert choir. And I remember saying to Lynn Warren, if I pass out, you're going to have to come in and get me because that's a lot of kids in there.
Mrs. Hansen grew up with music inspiration all around her.
Well, when I was little, I grew up in a very musical family, and everybody took piano lessons, and my dad was an amazing singer, like probably one of the best singers I've ever heard. My mom was a piano player, and so, you know, there was music everywhere. And then my mom always had stacks of music.
Mrs. Hansen has many music groups that she conducts.
So I've always been in charge of the freshman girls, and the concert choir, and the vocal jazz ensembles, of which I have two now. I have vocal jazz and ladies jazz.
Co-worker Mrs. Malin has worked very close with Mrs. Hansen over the years.
She's great. She and I compliment each other a lot.
Mrs. Malin appreciates Mrs. Hansen's skills and learns something from her every day.
We work with the same girls a lot of times, and so what she does well, I don't do as well, so it's kind of nice. She's got strengths where I have weaknesses, so it's great.
She brings a certain mood to the music groups.
I think she's brought in some significant things, especially like in the vocal jazz area. And she also brings in just a calmness and a perfection to the singing that I think is really important.
Change is everything, and sometimes it takes some getting used to.
I think transition's hard for everybody, so you're kind of ready to explore and relax.
Retirement is the time for those who are ready to enjoy their life and do what they want to do.
Travel a lot and see my family. My daughters are out west, one in Colorado, one in Montana. My parents are in North Dakota.
She doesn't have to answer to anyone.
I don't have to ask anybody permission to be gone for a long weekend anymore, so that's going to be lovely.
10th grader Aiden Endres shares his love on how Mrs. Hansen has helped him.
She likes to have a lot of fun, especially in vocal jazz.
There has been so many memories that were made and shared with Mrs. Hansen.
When we were prepping for the Christmas concert, we were all out on stage with microphones, and she took Ben Ashman's microphone and started rapping while Nate Schindler was beatboxing.
One thing I love about Miss Hansen is there's always interesting moments where she just tries to like quirk things up a bit, so she like adds little fun things you never knew that she had in her. So she surprises you when you least expect it.
She adds something fun and creates a loving and fun atmosphere for her students.
It has been really fun for the past 2 years being in your vocal jazz. You are the most memorable teacher here. Thank you for being a great teacher for the past 4 years and for giving me the opportunity to be in your vocal jazz.
I'm Cora Anderson reporting for The Ekko.
It is going to be a sad and hard goodbye to see Miss Hansen go. HHS will miss you. We wish you many years of happy retirement. As a former student of hers, I can confirm that Miss Hansen is super dedicated to our amazing music program. Speaking of dedicated people at her school, last week a lot of students were inducted into the National Honor Society. These amazing students are devoted to helping the community as well as accelerating in academics. This year, the Honor Society has many awesome students involved in it, and I know the new kids inducted next year will continue to make HHS proud. Keep up the good work, guys! And while we're on the subject of academics, we all know what it's like to be in our everyday classes like math, English, social studies, etc. But have you ever noticed all that racket down in the industrial tech pod? The Ekko's Carter Biermeyer went and saw what it was all about.
Many of our HHS students are enrolled in many classes in the 1B pod, a part of the school where many students don't even go or don't even know what it's all about. Yes, industrial technology. Consisting of some favorite classes for many HHS students. Basic Woodworking, or WOODS, is a class designed to give students an opportunity to learn and use machine technology and create beautiful woodworking pieces. And one particular student in the class has a passion for woods and all it has to offer.
It's kind of fun building with your hands, so being able to be in woods and be with DEETS.
Jalen Frantro.
Well, yeah, I do love woods, and I love like the, I know it's just weird, but like I like the going into the room and like the smell of just like the outdoors.
A student in woods who is hardworking and very talented at her craft.
I think in middle school, when we were able to do that little segment in wood shop, helped me like decide, yes, I want to be in basic woods. I want to keep doing that through my high school career.
She loves the class.
Yeah, they're really fun classes, and being able to not think about math and English, I can open my mind up and actually like relax sometimes, be in between classes.
But she's not only enrolled in woods.
I take metals and rec vehicles, which means I also took small engines and basic woods before this.
And one project in particular that she's working on right now.
Right now I'm building a tack locker for like my saddles.
Is something she's very excited about.
I always wanted one, but they're so expensive, but now I'd be able to make it my own.
And being one of the few girls in woods.
Girls should be able to open their minds into industrial tech class.
She wishes more would step outside of their comfort zone and take industrial tech classes.
I don't think girls understand that it may be awkward at first, but they're not gonna be like, oh, you're a girl in this class, get out of here. No, they're like wanting you to learn and keep learning.
Even boys in the class wish more girls would take industrial tech.
Mainly males taking it and having a female in a class is a little different. It's something to get used to, but I really enjoy it.
And even Mr. Dietz.
We really would like to have more females in our class just to equal out the classes.
Can agree that the gender norm should be defeated.
And she is something that she's related to. She likes horses, so it's a project that ties in with horses and is something that she will use.
So if you are interested in woods.
Just the hands-on work to create something that you can take home and it's yours, it's not someone else where you buy it.
Or any industrial tech class.
People think it's a stereotypical hick pod, but it is a really fun place to have fun and enjoy instead of being in all my AP and CIS.
Step outside of your comfort zone and learn some new life skills that you wouldn't learn in a typical math or English class. And if you are a girl who is interested, take after Jalen, because she's doing what she loves without a care in the world.
But like the favorite thing I built probably was like my cutting board for my mom, just like the design and effort I put into that.
I'm Carter Biermeyer reporting for The Ekko.
Woods is not your stereotypical high school class by any means. If it appeals to you, step over to the IT and ask Mr. Dietz all about it. Steps of another kind were on the move the past Friday in global languages. Around 24 Spanish students gathered in the music pod for Baila. That's a fun Spanish dancing experience. It looks like hard work to me, but everyone seemed to be enjoying it. The Spanish Club-sponsored experience is now in its 10th year, and this year was led by Hastings alumni Cece Roach. On the subject of speaking a foreign language, imagine leaving your friends and your family for nearly a whole year, traveling to another part of the world and having all your classes in a language you can barely understand. Three students have spent the last 7 months doing exactly that, and more. Here's the Ekko's Trevor Zion with the story.
The foreign exchange program,
it's such an enriching thing,
is something that many students here might not know about.
I experienced my first snow here, which was very interesting.
This year, Hastings welcomed three exchange students into our school.
Everybody's really nice. The school, yeah, that's been really fun.
This year, we welcomed Sarah from Morocco, Lucas from Germany, and Alicia from Poland. There have been some tough adjustments.
School days are long. Like, you spend the whole day in school. While, like, back home, we spend, like, a little bit in the morning, and then we can go back and rest and have lunch with our families and then come back, so.
The wording. Sometimes, like, I'm thinking of something I want to say, and I'm saying it, but I'm saying it wrong. And nobody's understands me or like laugh or like, I mean, like makes fun of me. And I know it's funny. It is. And it's sometimes like it comes out hilarious.
While others have been getting used to it more.
My favorite class is probably physics, because I have the feeling that I really learn something there and not just sit there until the hour is over.
They all had their own thoughts on our American foods.
I'm more used to like mild taste, and here I got like more spicy things.
While our food may have more spiciness,
Americans eat more meat, and overall it's less healthy, I'd say.
How we eat is another change.
It's more of like one plate, and everyone like shares one plate around the table.
The host families do a lot for the students.
We wanted to learn different cultures, different ways of life.
Olivia Van Vossen is Alicia's host sister.
We'll play games together, we watch movies together, go shopping a lot.
But this isn't the Van Vossen's first time hosting a student.
Well, we've hosted two before, so it's just been kind of different. We wanted to learn different cultures, different ways of life. We hosted one this year just because my sisters both left for college, so we wanted, it got really quiet. She's made the house pretty loud. She's filled the silence.
The exchange students have gotten to know each other very well.
Yeah, we knew each other through like the link crew and that stuff.
And two of them are even going to prom together.
I'm going with Alice, that's the other exchange student from Poland. And yeah, I have no idea how it's gonna be like. It's my first prom and probably my last one.
These students are all very thankful for their new experiences in the US.
This journey here is like, it was crazy. Like I felt that I grew up on like so many levels, like mentally.
Be sure to say hey when you see them on the dance floor. I'm Trevor Zion, reporting for The Ekko.
Make sure when you see these great students in the halls to say hi. They're happy to be here. And make sure to catch Alice and Lucas at prom. Despite the crazy weather we've been having in the last week or so, the Ultimate Frisbee students have found time to catch up on their sport. These athletes aren't just playing around. They work super hard and are preparing for their upcoming games, just like any other organized sport. These athletes play away games with all their familiar competitors, such as Red Wing, Egan, and Apple Valley, while playing at their home games at Featherstone across from the YMCA. Hey, that's a wrap for today's show. Wishing you all a good Friday. I'm Cindy Cater. Have a relaxing long weekend. We'll be back on a regular 5-day schedule next week and for the rest of the school year. See you next time on The Ekko. Hold on tight to your dream. Hey!